up to we're gonna get noise moving. If this brings up more noise, then we're gonna have to turn.
Sorry. I'm thinking that's noise boulevard. It's not. It's a different.
That's Norbury.
Yeah, Norbury. Sorry.
I'm still trying to teach crowds to be self-loud.
Oh, look, I'm comfortable.
Well, anywhere within a 300-kilometer radius of Wagga, I'm fine with it.
Oh, that was really scary the other day. Mum's on the phone talking to me about something. You know, accident somewhere. And I said, oh, yeah, that's you know, that's between here and here. And, yeah. Oh, mate, what's his face? Used to live here. He's like, who the fuck do you remember that?
Okay. Now, because Macca rang me up one day and he goes, oh, what's a shortcut from Yass to get that in Griffith or something? Yeah, you go through the cut across the back.
Yeah, Naz has called me. Naz has called me. He's, oh, how are you, mate? There's an accident down in between Woodburn and Grafton. What's the back way? I said, through Grafton, over the Bendy Bridge, Summerland Way, up to the sign that says Lawrence, turn right.
Actually, you know, it's a narrow bridge. That one at Taree.
I've never been over it.
It is narrow. It's fucking, I passed the B-double on there, my coach, and I swear I was about that.
That's the old highway. Oh, it's yeah, no, he's called, yeah, Daz calls me up all the time. He's like, oh, mate, I need your local knowledge. He said, go up to Lawrence.
Yeah, well, Daz sent me a message once. He goes, oh, yeah, we're about to come for a walk. You might come for a run on the
yeah,
he's
done that
to me. Freight liner.
Yeah.
Sounded good, that bit.
I remember the video you put up.
Yeah, yeah.
He's called me before, like, genuinely called me before. He goes, yeah, mate, I need your help. I'm coming up to BP, the twin BPs at Caboolture. I said, yeah, mate. He goes, mate, I've run out of hours on my logbook. Can I borrow yours?
Yeah, you told me that.
So one problem, Daz, he's like, what's that?
What's his record for how many he does?
He says his logbook is based on a true story, just not in that order. Doing a logbook check, he goes, mate, do me a favour. He goes, I'm at the end of my shift, I really don't want to do any paperwork. He says, make sure this fucking logbook goes out the window and you lose it, eh?
Yeah.
So I'm jail for what's in here. It's like, yeah, righto.
You mind that shit in the trailer? Right. Oh, I couldn't stop laughing when I got that snow course. I had the thing.
Oh, yeah, I saw that.
And I thought,
I think I know what Brad's
just said. Yeah. That's the first thing I thought of.
I was watching Outback Truck, that's the first episode of the new series.
I was watching that too.
Did you see the bloke with the big turbine wing and there was a log truck coming back the other way? He wouldn't pull over it on the pass. All I could think of was a fucking log trucks.
Yeah.
How good's that turbo? Who reminds me? We need to get Daz on that show, Outback Truckers.
I see he's bought himself a new truck.
Yeah, he's got the star. He lives out the back of Oakville, around the back of Tony's depot, Daz.
Turbo, he's
bought himself a new truck.
He wants world domination, that bloke.
He's not going to get that too fast of one truck.
You know what shits me on Outback Trackers though? They blur out the logos, but you can clearly see what sort of truck it is.
Yeah.
I don't know why they do that.
It's right.
city, off you go. No deaths, no rides, no nothing.
I had it seem.
And I looked at it, and that seemed just looked like foreign language.
Yeah.
So anyways, I remember old Harry in Elvis City. Just following the nicest old lady. Give her a free trip, she'll show you where to go.
Yeah,
sure
enough.
First trip. She says, oh, you're a new love, I haven't seen you before.
Yeah.
I said, yeah, but I know where I'm going either. She said, that's all right, I do. She sat with me for 7 trips.
Yeah?
7 trips.
Have you got a school kid like that on the school run?
I was about to say, school runs are the best.
You go on the freight and you go,
no, they're not.
Nah, some kids are right.
I hate school runs.
Yeah,
there was
oh, yeah, I'll come get. I said, you know where to go? Yeah, I said, you
get
on a license. I said,
yeah.
You
get
all those rides? Aren't you all those rides? Which is easier than me reading it as I
was. Yeah, I did the school run out of the Patricia Brothers in Fairfield. Same thing, they said just be what looks like the intelligent kid. Get him to show you.
Yeah.
So this one kid gets on, he says, mate, I know where to go, I'll show you. All the other kids started laughing, I thought nothing of it.
Yeah. Got off in the first stop?
No, what happened was he took me, he was actually the last kid to get off.
Yeah.
So he took me in reverse. So I actually started where we finished. And he got off and said, thanks, mate.
I simply pull over, turn the aircon steerage and everything off and go, right, this is how it's going to work. It's Friday afternoon and you want to get home. If someone wants to get home early and on time, I suggest someone come down and show me where to go.
Yeah.
9 times out of 10, someone will come through and get
home. I was so angry with that kid. And when I got back to FI, I did see the funny side of it. I've got a smart little basket.
Yeah.
Didn't some school kid want to go you once? What did you like?
Yeah. We were doing the same thing in Fairfield. We were doing round service and a couple of buses parked by. It's just a normal bus route. And it was midday. You meant to be in school. They all get off. I tried to show me their bus pass.
This has changed since I've been here in your life.
Yeah, it's near our place.
Well, that was the only thing here, and that's where the T-Way finished.
Yeah.
Oh, T-Way goes all the way.
No, that's when I first came here, that's where we had to get off. Anyway, sorry, go on.
These kids got on a bus at Park High and they tried to show me their school pass and I said, no, boys, you know better than that.
Yeah.
It's a fair. Oh, blah, 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 school's finished, all this bullshit. I said, listen, mate, you and I both know school's not finished, but I don't care, as long as you pay fair.
That's
the
deal.
So they paid their fare, they sat up the back, F this, see, and all this shit. And they had old ladies on board, you know.
Yeah.
And one of the ladies came up to me and said, can you ask them to stop swearing, please?
Yeah.
So I pulled over and I said, listen, boys, I don't care what you do or say on the bus, but you can't swear. I've got old ladies on the bus, I don't want to hear it. So just tone your language. Yeah. What's that noise you're saying?
Yeah.
I've tried all sorts of things. I used to, when it got too loud, I wouldn't say anything to them, I'd just pull over, open the door.
Yeah, it's always.
So I'd turn the bus off and get out of smoke.
Yeah, I used to do the same thing. So they wouldn't have a smoke, I'd just sit down on your phone and.
Yeah, I'd stand there with 3 or 4 snakes and the kids come out and say, what are we doing? And we'll shut up. We'll get going.
Yeah.
Well, the other thing was, if you're in an air-conditioned bus and it was 40 degrees, I'd turn those heat up.
Oh, right. No, I'd turn it off.
I remember a few times having the drivers with no air conditioning. I'm choking. And I'd sat on in the bus before.
Yeah.
And they'd say, your air conditioning's broken. I said, no, it's not. Your mouth's open. It's the heat coming out of your mouth.
Yeah.
If you shut up, the air conditioning will work. So they go, why don't you turn it back down?
My favourite was Mueller College. No, Grace Mueller was alright. Grace College used to be really, really feral, but not so bad now. It used to be really, really feral. We used to have this, we still have school run too. And it goes all the way to what we call Walt Disney Land, or rich kids live. Because, you know, there's big houses that look like Walt Disney.
Yeah, the elites.
Anyway, so.
Who's that?
Anyway, so. Loaded over, you used to get a full standing load on that one, and they used to be that loud. You know, you go to a rock concert and you have the feel of distortion in your ears, that's how loud it was. So I thought, oh, okay, well, I said one of two things. So I tried putting it on SBS FM and turning it up full blast, and it didn't work. So I thought, what's the most annoying song I've got on my iPod? I thought, I know, Agadoo. I put it on constant rotation, and every time the song would start again, I'd just keep turning it up louder and louder and louder and louder until the stereo went full blast. 34 times it played before one kid came down and said, can we have the music off? And I said, yep, the music will go off as soon as you go quiet. Bang. Went quiet, never had a problem since.
Oh, yes.
It's got a pretty strong
talk. Yeah, it did, absolutely.
going, I didn't. Every year, I run to my body.
We had a big set the other day, the midday, they had basically that it's free for all. They opened the phone lines up. You can request anything. Some of them had cows with guns the other day. That's a good sing along with that. I haven't heard this in years.
Remember, I was coming into Fairfield Station one day, around the ocean, but on the school time, I always drop them off for the school kids, and they'd always fucking stand right on the edge.
I love hitting them with the mirror.
That's right. I'm sitting tight and telling them that's standing there, so I'm glad I'm going to give it the mirror.
Yeah.
You're fucking hippie. I said, yeah, you're bugging the mirror. I said, no, you're bugging the mirror.